Hello and welcome to Pickle's Garage for part 2 of the head gasket repair. My part 1 showed entire disassembly. We're now at the point where we're going to be putting on the new head gasket, and I'm going to go over torque specs as well as important steps for you to reassemble your engine the right way the first time. Let's dive into it. So after you've gone over every surface and just make sure it's as smooth as possible, I took a razor to all this just to make sure that there's no remaining gasket and it's a flat, clean surface. Your new head gasket, if you get a decent quality one, it does have a margin of error, you know, if there's different kind of ridges on it, but you just want to give it the best chance possible to have a very, very clean, smooth surface for it to connect this piece and the top of the headpiece. So we're going to take this out. And it's gonna have a couple different layers. It's gonna have multiple metal layers, and then it's going to have an actual kind of pliable layer in the center. We're going to line it up easy enough. It just goes to the holes here. So straight back like that. Straight on the front like this. So now we have our head back in place, and we have temporarily put our bolts in place. Now, none of these have any, these are all finger tight. None of these have any sort of torque to them because there is a very important order that you're going to be putting these in. So as you remember, these ones with the bigger threads on the outside, and then these ones without the nub, with the nub, no nub, no nub, no nub, with the nub, and no nub. So the second one in on the far side and the second one in on the near side have the nub. Everything else is normal. So like I said, they are all just in place. Now I'm gonna set up, I'm gonna try and get a good camera angle. Basically, you're going to be at the driver's side when you're looking at this, and we're going to count off specific bolts that we start with and certain torques. So you'll notice that this one is missing currently. And the reason is because this one is actually water jacketed, and so it is important to get like a thread sealant. Permatex is a pretty standard one. All you have to do is follow the directions. Essentially it just says don't put it at the very end, just do a little bit, not too many threads, but just a little bit towards the bottom. Make sure you get the one that's up to 400 degrees, you want the high temp. But I'm gonna go ahead and wait until I'm starting to do this tightening. So let me get in a good position where I can show you the order, and this is where you're going to need that torque wrench. Okay, so like I said, starting from the driver's side, you're going to be going to the very middle bolt. So 1, 2, 3, 4 in. You'll see this is the very middle one, okay? So this is the first bolt. Now what we're gonna start with is we're going to start with 22 pounds, okay? And we're gonna go in the order I'm about to show you. Once we're done doing 22 pounds, we're gonna do 45 pounds, okay? Once we're done doing 45 pounds, we're going to verify that everything in this order is at 45, because it might be 45 and then everything gets crunched and then, you know, it's less. So we're gonna do 45 twice. And then we're going to do 110. The only one that's not going to have 110 is going to be this front one, okay? That's going to be 100. Now, I'm going to go over this, but some people learn in the moment, some people learn ahead. So once again, 1, 2, 3, 4, that's our middle one, right? So that's going to be the first one you start at. And we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Okay, so starting again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Once again, you're gonna see me doing this, but just so you know the order of it, you're just gonna be walking it around, okay? And that's to get an even spread. So let's go ahead and start. Like I said, we're gonna start with 22. Let me get set up. You get your torque wrench, You can get the really fancy ones or you can get these pretty cheap, but it is very important that you're torquing this to spec. And naturally, this is going to be a little easier to show on the scale when I'm doing 22, not 100. So I'm going to show you. It's very easy. You just follow this spec. You're just going to keep turning it, okay? So super loose right now, not even registering anything, okay? We're going to follow this. Okay, still very loose. Now we're starting to get to 20. Okay. You want to do smooth rotations here so you can get a read on it. So this will probably do it right here. So we got, right there. So we're right at 20. So that is good. And then like I said, we're going to move down to our second position. And then we're going to start doing 22. So I'm going to now get these all to 22, and then I'll set up and I'll show you guys 45. Like I said, you're just going to follow that order, okay? Alright, so I'm now at the point where I'm going to be putting in number 11, technically. And so, like I mentioned, I'm not going to worry about putting any of it in these front threads. Wow, help if I showed you, right? These front threads, it's just going to be more back here. So just going to mix it all around, and as this threads, it's going to spread itself out, but I just like to kind of do it more like this. You don't have to do anything crazy. This is probably more than enough, but I'm only putting on one bolt, might as well do the works here. Alright. Massive globby mess. All right, here we go. Perfect, so now we're at roughly 22 for everything, and now, once again, we're going to be starting in the fourth one in, right here, and now we're going to be doing 45 in the same exact order. Here. And this is going to be a decent workout. Not so much the 45, but doing a bunch of 45 and then doing 45 again, and then once we start getting into the hundreds, it's decent. So, in an effort not to make this a longer video than it probably already is, I'm just going to knock these out, and then I will continue with the rest of our rebuild here. Make sure you stick around for the rockers, because that is also something that needs to be torqued to spec. Easy as that. So we have all of them on. All these are 110. Double check, make sure everything's 110 after you finish everything, same order. And then you're gonna finish off the last one, number 11 here, with 100 even. So not so bad. Now we're going to put the rods back in the exact same place where we took them out at. And then we're gonna put the rockers same place where we took them out at. There is going to be one little added piece here. We are going to actually be putting on, let me see if I have it readily available. I'm gonna grab it real quick. All right, so high performance assembly lube is kind of that secret added ingredient. Is it overkill? Maybe. So essentially, because all of this has been taken apart and exposed to the elements, even if you're doing it all same day, stuff dries, right? And your engine really requires oil everywhere. And so what this does is it's a little bit thicker and it's a little bit better at staying where you put it. And so when you do your first initial startup, this makes sure that it's not going to be metal on metal when you're initially running, which could cause a little bit of damage. So, you know, ideally once your engine is running and warming up and everything, it'll be fine. It'll be like your normal car, but because you've taken apart everything, adding this will help. And so specifically where I'm going to be adding this is I'm going to add it to each of the tops of these, right? Because this is where the rocker is connecting to. So you want to eliminate engine, or you want to eliminate metal rubbing here. And then I'm also going to put one kind of dot on each side of the rod that you're about to see put in. The reason you don't want to do too much is, you remember those holes seeing straight through it? You don't want to plug those up. Yes, oil should eventually push through it, but this is to aid in reducing that damage. You don't want to, you know, add to it by interfering with the normal oil process. So a little bit of dabs on each of these and one bit on each of the rods and we'll be good to go. So once you've put all of the rods back in place, it'll slide pretty easily into the position that it needs to stay in. So don't worry about that too much, but it'll just kind of slide them all in, replace the rockers, get them at least a little bit kind of finger tight and get them all in place. And then now we're going to actually torque them to spec. So easy enough, the torques on these are around 19 to 21 foot pounds. So if you get in the 20 range, you're good, but you need to make sure that there's no actual load on them with the rod coming up. So that means you do have to rotate the engine. It's really not that hard. It's actually a lot easier if you take out the spark plugs. So if you take all your spark plugs along the side here with one of those deep socketed 5/8, then it'll be even easier to rotate. But you're just going to grab a 3/4 socket size and it's going to go on that crank right there, the lower bolt in the center. And then if you have a cheater bar, it gives you that kind of that extension. And then all you're going to do is you're going to rotate it while feeling these, or even here, either way. And you're just going to wait for, I usually wait for it to lift. And then once it starts coming down and then it stops and it rests, that's how I know there's 100% no load on it. And that's when I would tighten this to 20. So really, if you're rotating it around and you're feeling these, just put your fingers on this and you just wait for it to not be in motion up or down, not at the high point at all. At the low point where there's no load on it whatsoever, and that's when you are tightening it. So it's gonna be a little hard to do with two hands, so I'm gonna try and do at least this front one where it's easy to look at, and then I'll do the rest of them, and then we'll get back to kind of re-adding all of our fun stuff. So let me show you how to torque these. You're gonna pull out your torque wrench once again. Okay, so we're gonna make sure that we have this on the crank, and like I said, I'm just gonna hold these. You'll see this one's already kind of lifted, so we're just gonna keep rotating. And if you can tell, my pointer finger is starting to descend ever so slightly, and then it stopped. So there's no more load on this one, and so I'm just going to go ahead and put this on here. And I'm going to tighten it. And then this is a size 1/2. It's gonna be very loose because I just had these finger loosened. So we're just gonna lock this in until we get to 20 foot pounds. And then we're gonna keep on going. And you're just gonna keep rotating until you get in the lowest resting position. And once it's not moving at all, not going up, not going down, it's in the lowest position, you'll tighten it to 20-ish foot-pounds with that half socket. You'll just walk on down, and then now we're gonna start the rest of the reassembly. So we'll run through everything pretty quick just because we're just putting it all back now. You'll see the valve cover is in place. I did put a new gasket there. There's a grommet that I need to replace over there, so I haven't actually put the valve cover fully on yet, but I did just put it in place so nothing gets inside. I will run through, as a reminder, some of the things that you have to put back in place. You'll remember you had that sensor there that's a size 12. You're gonna have to put your alternator bracket back on, and that is a 9/16. There's four of them. And then the alternator itself is going to have that top bolt and that lower bolt. That is a 5/8. And then you're going to want to put the power supply back to it, that red cable, that is a size 12. And then this just clips back into place. And then you're also going to be putting your pulley drive back in place. I believe that was also a 9/16. Let me double check here. Yep, 9/16. You're gonna put that right back in place. And then you're going to be putting your cap back on for your thermostat housing. I did replace my thermostat with a high flow one. I went with the OEM temperature, which is 195. They have lower, they have higher, but then they also have 195 that has high flow, and that's what I replaced this with. Don't forget to replace the gasket back in there as well, and that is a size half, upper, lower. I'm gonna clean those off and replace them, and then we're gonna start putting everything back on this side. You'll remember that the last thing to come off on this side was the exhaust. So next scene, you'll see me putting back the exhaust in place, and then eventually I'll be putting back the intake and reattaching all the electronic components. So I have new spark plugs and I've replaced the coil pack. Don't forget the plug in the back and that little safety pin. So you just have to slide it up in, click that red tab back in. I did replace my ground strap, size 10 for this, 7/16 or 11 on this one, and it is 1, 2, 3 back is where that ground strap goes. So make sure you replace your ground strap, that's very important. This goes back over here. Mine did break, as yours might too. All these plastic bits are just kind of falling apart, but it just goes back on like that. Right in place, and let's see, I think that's everything. Like I said, I replaced the coil pack, I replaced the hoses back in their position and slid that on top, so we're pretty much good for this side, and now we're gonna finish up on the other side. So moving over to this side, we have the exhaust that we're putting on now. These ones you can get all the way tight, one on either side, right? And then this you'll need just to make sure that it doesn't droop, but you can't tighten this all the way just yet, just because this washer actually holds against the intake as well. So I got them in and loose, that way I don't have to try and find it from underneath. I am tempted to put the exhaust directly back on now that I have all this access, but the thing is, you're probably gonna need that extra room with the exhaust off to do these bolts. But we can go ahead and throw the intake back on now and then start attaching everything else. All right, so I'm gonna end here, as this is definitely my longest video, but everything, all these clips, they just kind of go back into place. Everything for the most part has its own shape, and then you just have to re-push in all the safety plugs. You gotta do all your 9/16 bolts there, top and bottom, and then just put them exactly how we took them off. So certain different lengths going along, and then probably the hardest sensors to find are going to be these O2 sensors, one in the front, one in the back. That's just because they've fallen down at this point. You just have to find the exhaust, travel it back up, put on your fuel line here, clip it back into place. So it is a little bit of retracing your steps, but like I said, this is definitely a longer video, so I want to make sure that you guys see all this, but it's also not too daunting. This one's a little dirty. Make sure to check your plugs. I'm gonna clean this out and then I'll clip it back in where it needs to go. But yeah, that's basically it. I'm gonna put the bottom exhaust back on, and then I'm gonna put my air intake, and then we are good to go. So thank you very much for watching. Feel free to like and subscribe if you made it this far. You're a real one. I mean, I know this was kind of a long thing, but I wanted to be as detailed as possible and make sure to not leave you guys hanging. So thanks again.